After discovering her factory and the surrounding city in danger of being invaded by beings from other worlds, CEO Katya Volskaya immediately began work on a new mech series to defend her homeland from the denizens of the Nexus. Now, the Triglav Protector is ready for testing. Volskaya Foundry is a medium-sized, three-lane battleground. At the top, center, and bottom of the foundry sit three control points. Periodically, a control point will activate, and teams must vie for control of the point to acquire a massive mech vehicle. Ownership of a point can be gained by standing inside the designated area. However, if an enemy happens to also enter the area, the point will become contested until the foe is eliminated. Once a team assumes possession of a point, they will begin to accrue victory progress at a steady rate. Teams must remain in the area to continue this progress, as stepping away will eventually return the point to a neutral state. As in Overwatch, if a control point reaches 99% and an enemy remains to contest, the point will enter an overtime state. This overtime state will only last a few seconds, but it is reset whenever an enemy player steps onto the point. Once a team's victory progress finally hits 100%, they will close out the objective and initiate deployment of a Triglav Protector. The Protector is similar to other piloted objectives in Heroes of the Storm, like the Dragon Knight or Garden Terror, but it is unique as a two-person vehicle. The first person to enter the Protector will assume its pilot position. This player will control the mech's movement and use of sieging and support abilities. Charge will propel the Protector toward a targeted enemy's position, dealing area damage around it and double damage to structures and minions. Rocket Fist launches a concussive fist that will root the first hero it hits or disable a targeted structure for a brief period of time. When activated, Shield Emitter will provide the mech armor and grant a shield to allies in its proximity. The second person to enter the Protector will take on the gunner position and has access to a deadly set of damage-dealing abilities. After a range-defining windup, the Protector's particle cannon can launch a projectile to a target location, dealing area damage upon impact. The mech can also initiate Gatling Cannon, unleashing an ongoing barrage of missiles at your cursor location for a brief period. Or activate its Scorching Laser to cut a line in the terrain that will trigger a delayed explosion for heavy damage. In addition to the Protector, spread across Volskaya Foundry are five mercenary camps, two siege camps, two turret mercs, and a singular support camp. Utilize the pushing power and activatable resources from these camps to bolster your team's aggression and push further into enemy territory. The control points across Volskaya are unique in a few ways. Each layout is different and will require you to engage the objective with a variety of tactical strategies. On top of that, the addition of moving conveyor belts around the points brings a dose of chaos that can amplify your team's approach or stifle it completely. Make sure you understand the direction each conveyor belt is moving around your point when you decide to engage or retreat. Even if your back is against the wall and it looks like the enemy is about to capture a point, do not lose hope. If you defensively dive a point before it hits 100%, the enemy cannot secure victory with you present. Safely hold your ground and get your team to back you for a team fight that could turn the tide. You do not want to underestimate the power of the Triglav Protector. In the hands of talented players, this mech can unload a ridiculous amount of damage. Volskaya Foundry is primed to test its remarkable new technology. How are you with mechs? Ready to be a pilot? A gunner? Or just a test dummy? We'll see you in the Nexus.